Good morning, Chicago.
Good morning.
How are you?
I am just great.
How'd you sleep?
Good. How did you sleep?
Nate, how did you sleep? Good?
Oh, Nate, you were on the couch.
How was it? Nate had to sleep on the couch here at the Airbnb.
Airbnb lied.
Did it at least fold out to a bed?
No.
Let's see it. Let's see it. Oh, that doesn't look so great.
Can you see? That looks like complete crapola.
Let me try.
Look how thin that thing
is. Let me try. Oh.
Okay. Big lad.
Oh, this is so comfy. Poor Nay. Tomorrow, I think, or tonight, I think we'll have to sleep up here. And
we'll
she can sleep
Nay.
In the bed.
Okay. I really would have switched for you.
Guys, we are out here. This is our Chicago vlog. We're in Chicago for Courtney's mom's wedding. Well, it already happened. So we decided to get an Airbnb here in the city because I've never really stayed downtown Chicago. So I think before we start the day, we need to stretch because my back is jacked up. I haven't been able to lift. This is now fifth day. I will not be lifting, but I kind of want to start doing some yoga. Coffee. Time to get coffee. It's about 8 a.m. and it feels so good to have a little bit of stretching done at least.
Yeah, so nice.
We're gonna start waking up and doing that more. My back already feels better, a little bit better today. But
Tesla.
Oh, beautiful Tesla. So the plan is to see Chicago today. Try to get a workout in somewhere. Go to the Bean, eat some donuts. Get this green coffee Courtney keeps talking about.
It's a matcha latte.
Whatever. And then also to see Navy Pier, some other sites. There's some crazy hot dog place I wanna try. There's some cool popcorn stuff I wanna try. There's some deep dish I wanna try.
Oh my lord.
What?
Deep dish is tomorrow. You can't eat all
right, deep dish. Deep dish will
be
tomorrow.
Me and Steve have a rule. It's like one bad thing a day. Maybe since we're here.
Except for when you're in Chicago and it's the best food city in America. Yeah, I said it. Sorry, New York. Sorry, New Orleans. Sorry, Miami. Sorry, LA. I don't know if anyone thinks LA has the best food. Best food trucks, maybe. When in Chicago, we eat like we do in Australia. This is what we're having this morning. Oh, that looks amazing here. We're at the restaurant at the bottom of the Soho House here in Chicago, and it's pretty fancy, but I think that I need a membership at the Soho House. I think you have to get nominated by two people, so Lewis House, I nominate you to nominate me. What did you get over here?
Quinoa pancake.
Nice.
With some berries, two poached eggs.
You swing that with me. They got that.
Pretty excited. Baby, oh, you got salmon and your sausage.
I didn't want salmon. All right, bon appetit.
We're gonna get up and come
with a full stomach, we are off to go train. Gotta get the training in. So hopefully be my first training session, if I can do it with the back. We're gonna go meet my good friend Patrick, who's a lawyer here, works downtown. So we're gonna go meet up with him and get a session in. Are you still full from breakfast?
Yes. I didn't share my pancake with you though.
You did.
You had one.
I had a bite of your pancake. I'm super full and I don't feel like I ate that much, but here's what happened though. I ate a lot of fat. I had sausage, two eggs, avocado. I never get fat, that high of fat, before a pre-workout meal because it's hard to, it digests more slowly. So carbohydrates and protein are typically what I stick to eat about an hour before. That was definitely a heavy, heavy meal. But as long as we get in some form of training today,
did a little yoga, and we're doing a lot of walking around. Today was a back bicep day. Fortunately, we didn't get to film any of it because they didn't allow cameras in there. Kind of got a little piece on my phone, but tried to keep everything stable so we didn't hurt our back. I think we did an okay job. I only had once that it kind of gave me a sharp pain. It's kind of what to be expected my first day back. When training around an injury, it's one of those things that I always like to err on the side of caution. So if you guys are in the gym, make sure you are, I guess, really treating it treating it like you, like it's the first day. You know, you get back into the gym, you might feel great. It only takes one little movement and all of a sudden you're back to where you started. So we're gonna continue to walk around the city because all I know is being back in the gym, I can definitely tell how out of shape I am. So I need to walk, I need to lay off the donuts, and I need a nap right now. So we're going back and we're taking a nap before we go out and sightsee.
Yo, that is my jam right there. Steve's Flower Shop.
All right, we finally made it. Babe took us like on a 25, 30 minute walk. Which is good because that means we can have more donuts. What's the name of this place?
Sawadi.
That was close. And all I know is they have really cool graffiti on the door, so you know it's gonna be really good coffee. You know, the more dungy it is, the better coffee it is.
Hey, check it! A boxing!
They have boxing here? Oh, that's dope as hell. That's super cool. So this is apparently what we came all the way for. We got my latte, my camo donut because we love everything camo and I will have a camo car.
Perfect little green tea.
It was a military latte.
A military latte, so it kind of plays on the camo theme.
And then Nana is over here.
My little one.
We're at the Bean. We made it all day. We went back and took a little bit of a nap. Not a big deal because we worked out. We have not eaten. Well, that's not true. I had one protein bar. Courtney had some trail mix, and that's been it. So, we've saved up our calories. I'm getting a hot dog. But guys, we're at the Bean. The beautiful Bean. So, and we're about to post this on Instagram. That. That's my photography skills.
That was pretty cool.
We're gonna throw a little hashtag in there. Hashtag the Bean. I'm not gonna lie, my Instagram story might be the best it's ever been today.
That's what
we, what do you recommend eating around
here? Don't say pizza, please.
What are you in the mood for?
I need a good Chicago hot dog first. Like maybe down at Navy Pier.
Portillo's.
Yeah, Portillo's. We got Portillo's in Phoenix, though. All those people today, I put it out asking where I should eat. And I was like, Portillo's, but there's Portillo's in Phoenix. A lot of people don't know that. Because besides Chicago, there's more Chicago people in Phoenix than any other city I've ever been in. Oh yeah, everyone I meet's like, where are you from? In Phoenix, like, oh, I'm from Chicago. So where they go to retire. Okay. Dinner time. Yes, I'm eating a salad with chicken. It doesn't have enough chicken. I'm trying to eat somewhat healthy to make up for the donut and the absolute shit show of a breakfast I had. It was delicious. And we also went to a place before here. We're restaurant hopping. Honestly, you know you love your girlfriend when you go to the restaurant she wants to go to. That was a fun-filled Chicago day. And to top it off, we've just done nothing but eat. Actually, that's not true. We had a big breakfast and we had a big dinner. And now we're gonna have some dessert because we did a lot of walking in between. And that's what I would suggest anyone who's traveling, who wants to experience things, try not to snack, try to walk everywhere, and then try to enjoy yourself too. What do we have here?
We have.
What?
Am I in this?
Yeah, you're in this.
Oh, I'm in this.
By the way, everyone, Courtney has a special announcement she's already made on her channel. She's pregnant. Yay!
What?
I'm just kidding. She's not.
Oh my gosh! No, definitely not.
She's not doing the Olympia. I just announced it for
you. Oh, yeah. What he said.
She already did a video on her channel, but she's not doing the Olympia, which is awesome, which means she can eat this ice cream with me. Because it's not very fun when you have to eat it on your own.
But that's not why, but we don't need to go into that.
She's doing it for health. She's had some health stuff. Go check it out. Go check out that video on her channel. We're going to link that to this video. All right, so we're big connoisseurs. Oh, shit.
Okay, well, the first bite.
You spilled the ice cream on the ground. On the table. Okay, we're big connoisseurs of dairy-free ice cream. And so, like, we love our dairy-free ice cream. Because I don't really do dairy that well. And we, our favorite up until this point is Natamu. The Halo Tops, the Arctic Zeros, while they're not bad, they have a lot of sugar alcohols, which leave me feeling a little bit bloated, in my opinion.
Very bloated.
They leave me feeling very bloated?
No, me. Huh. This is a different texture, but literally, there is no eggs, gluten, soy. It's vegan.
What flavor is that?
Cookie dough, but it tastes like banana.
It does taste like banana. And I'm not a banana fan.
It was a local ice cream. We bought it at Whole Foods. Like, so you can only get it in Chicago, so it's from like a local somewhere around here. But
yeah, F that. Sorry.
You don't like it? Like, no. For real.
That's not me. I don't like banana ice cream. That tastes like banana ice cream to me.
What about the cookie dough?
But it's surrounded by banana. Ah! The ice, when the ice cream's lava. Not the floor, the ice cream.
Nay, do you like banana?
Nay, can I have some of your mochis? I love mochi. To be honest, I already had two mochis.
I didn't.
You gonna give me a bite? Nay's gonna give me, I'm gonna take a bite of this one. Which one do you wanna take a bite of?
You can't.
I don't want the whole thing. Here you go. Ugh.
Gosh, just eat it already. What the hell?
They that was good.
This ice cream with me.
That mochi was so much better. All right.
Lame.
Next up, we have the vegan, made from real vegans. The vegan, you've heard me say that like 10 times and each time she laughs.
So dumb.
This is gluten-free, veganese carrot cake.
No Why joke. Why does it say cookies and cream? It says cookies and show them.
These desserts are having identity crises tonight. That's good.
You like it?
That's pretty good.
Can I try?
Those little veganese people know how to do their stuff. And don't, you guys, really I'm just joking. Thing. Sometimes people get mad at me for saying veganese.
Chicago
people need to lighten up these days. That's what I'm talking about. Have some freaking vegan food, like carrot cake. I could totally be vegan for a day. No, really, there's some awesome guys out there that are vegan bodybuilders. And I would love to be able to do that.
This is good.
I think it's great to be able to have that knowledge to pair those things. But in the meantime, I'll just smash some vegan carrot cake. Which brings me to my next point. You know you love your freaking girlfriend when you decide all the old restaurants you like to go to are now out the window because Courtney can't eat like 90% of the stuff on the planet.
That's because of my stuff.
What stuff?
It's not because I'm like being a little prima donna picky.
It's 50-50.
No, but for real, like it doesn't make me feel good.
When? Oh, to eat that stuff?
Yeah.
So you think eating vegan stuff makes you feel better?
No, but it's just, okay.
The point I'm getting at.
Eating vegans actually makes me feel the best.
The point I'm getting at is tonight, sometimes as a boyfriend, you have to sacrifice the deep dish pizza.
I'm getting you deep dish tomorrow.
Are you?
Remember I told you I was.
Lumanides or Giordano's?
Whatever you want, babe. I say Lou's.
Leave in the description. Wait, which one do they have in Phoenix?
Lou's.
Then we're going Giordano's.
Really?
I don't know. Lumanides or Giordano's. If you guys have had those, leave them in the comments below. And also, leave in the comment section below, deep dish or thin crust pizza. That's one we're going to do next.
Thin crust. And I'm from Chicago, and I like thin crust better.
That's blasphemous. You know what she said to me last year? I'm like, babe, I think the Cubs are going to win the World Series. What did you say?
I said, no, they're not.
She's from Chicago.
We were watching the Cubs game in
She
Hawaii.
Likes thin crust pizza and didn't think the Cubs were going to win the World
you
Series.
You guys, no. Don't.
When you guys watch this, go to Courtney's Instagram and just hashtag on her photo.
Baby.
Go Cubs go. Go Cubs go. Go Cubs go. Hey Chicago, what do you say? The Cubs are gonna win today. But oh, end of the video.
Bye.